Hi everyone, welcome to House Talks. Today's episode is about the garden tools. You know, gardening should be more fun and stress buster and exciting, but it should not be giving more stress. So I would say the using correct garden tools make it easier to do the gardening and all. So in today's episode, we are going to discuss about top 10 essential garden tools. I'll explain what I'm using, so I'll show one by one and all. I hope this video will help at least some new first-time home buyers and all. Let's get into the topic. The first one is my favorite tool is the hori knife. Some people call it soil knife, and I got this one recently, few months ago, but it's really a multifunctional garden tool, useful. So I just want to recommend and show it to you as the first. And this is what I'm talking about, the soil knife. This one really have a unique design. Let me show you. If you look at this soil knife, the design and all, the one side you have a serrated sewing edge, another one is a very sharp, and you see the end is a very sharp and pointed. I will show you I'll explain the purpose, why it is a multi-purpose tool. And the first thing, because of, you know, this is a sharp edge, so if you want to precisely take out the weed from the lawn, you can just cut around the weed and you can take it out with the roots, so that it's easy to take out the weeds in the lawn and it won't grow back. And if you look at that serrated edge, this is really useful for cutting and transplanting the plants and separation of plants. Meaning, I'll show you. Let's say I want to separate these perennials into off and divide and plant it again to separate areas. So this one is the serrated edge, really useful. I can go ahead and cut with, you know, along with the roof all the way, and I can separate the plant. So that's the useful. And this sharp edge also useful, you know, cutting for small branches and all. That's, and if you look at the design, it's a slightly in the curve. You can use as a like a hand trowel and also. And the another purpose, it has like a measurement up to 6 inches and all. If you want to plant bulbs or small flowers and all, you can just make it a hole, and you know, you want to go like up to 5 inch or 4 inch, and you can plant the bulbs and all. So I would say definitely it's my favorite garden tool, and it's a multi-purpose, and moreover, it's very handy, and it comes with a leather pouch, and it's easy to hold it and store it. The second one is a weeder tool. There are a lot of products in the market, different design to handle the weeds in the lawn. This one is more specifically designed for to handle the weeds at the narrow edges, you know, the walkway, or else, you know, near to the foundation. And more specifically, if any weeds are grown on the driveway or between the pavers, so it's easy to this, because of the very thin, narrow, sharp edge is very useful, and to take out the weeds from the, even not only the weeds, you know, if grass is grown between the pavers in the backyard or driveway, we can take out it very easily and very precisely, and you can take out the weeds with roots, so it won't grow back again. So it's definitely the I would recommend this weeder tool. Okay, third one, this one is call it grass shears. So basically to cut the grass, meaning like for example, you want to cut the grass at the edges or where, you know, close to the tight areas and all. So this is really useful. I use this a lot, and it has a locking system. So when you unlock, so it comes like this. So we can cut the lawn the grass or the edges, specifically where you know towards the foundation and all, it's really very useful. I will show you an example.
Ready?
Okay. So for example, if I want to cut the grass here, I can't use definitely the trimmer and edger here because I don't want to damage the pipes and all. So I use these grass shears here to cut around this area. It's a very compact and really useful. So I normally use all the way to cut the grass around, you know, that foundation area and all. So this is my one of the favorite tool. Okay, the next one is the bypass pruner. This one is really useful pruning for specifically for, you know, deadheading the perennials, or you want to, you know, cut the small branches precisely so you don't want to damage the texture of the branch, and you want to cut some flowers or some fruits or anything, you can use this one. It has a locking system. You can lock and we can open it, so it bypass all the way here, so we call it like bypass pruner. It's a very compact and handy, so I use this a lot. And there is a one more pruner, very handy and compact size. We call it like a garden snips. That's mostly like a straight and a smaller size, but that's really useful. Let's say you want to cut the like fruits or tomatoes in the garden, or you know, small tiny branches or flowers, you want to use that every day. So I would prefer to use that garden snips instead of the pruner. The pruner is a little bit, you know, that mid-sized branches, for example, like if you look at here, you know, that mid-sized small branch, if you want to, you know, cut it. So it's a very useful to cut it. So that's all about the pruner. The next one is the cutting power, that we call it this one loppers. The main purpose of loppers is, you know, the cutting a bigger branches over the tree which are, you know, little high. You can cut at least, you know, 3/4 inch diameter. Like you can cut easily, you know, this kind of tree branch very easily. It can cut that's the main purpose, you know, you want to cut the branches at the high. So it's a very useful, and if you look at this, you know, you can cut easily at least, you know, 1 inch diameter branch. These loppers are really powerful. The next one is I would call it this head shears. This is very powerful and useful. The main purpose of is, you know, we use this for, you know, to trim the shrubs hedges and all. So you can want to, you know, shaping up the bushes, you know, shrubs and all, you know, the front side, you know, yard and the rear yards where lot of shrubs are located, you want to trim it and shape it. So this is the one really very useful and very powerful, and you can use to cut the branches also, but the main the purpose of tool is to, you know, shape up the trim of the shrubs and, you know, the hedges and all. This one, next we talk about the raking. This one is, we call it like a bow rake. It's a very old one. I think I have been using this more than 10 years. It's still strong. So this one is, the purpose of is, we use for different areas, specifically if you want to level the ground, you know, where you put the compost and mulch and all. So you can level it, the soil and mulch like this, and you can use this in the garden beds for leveling and all. And you can use for, you know, raking for the things like this, but the main purpose is for the leveling the ground, you know, leveling the soil and compost and all. So this one is I think everyone knows the purpose of this one. This one is another raking, but the main purpose of this is, you know, cleaning up the yard, raking up all the leaves, especially after the fall season, during the fall season and winter season. And this we use a lot while cleaning the yard, fall time, winter time. And it comes in different designs. This is just a plastic one. This one also, like, I have been using more than 10 years. You see that teeth you can get in the metal design with adjustable and all. I would suggest, if you are planning to buy the adjustable one, so it's easy to reach compact areas to clean, especially around the garden bed and on the garden bed and all. So that's about the raking. Let's move to the next topic, shovels. So the shovels, there are a lot of variety of shovels in the market, and there are different names, like we call it, flat shovel, round shovel, and spade, trench shovel, all those things and all. I never bought all those kind of things. I had all the time one or two shovels only, and this is the one I use most of the times. This one is like a pointed round shovel. It's mostly useful for the digging and all. When I am planting, I try to dig and use for to take out the compost or soil, from one place to another, moving and throwing all this, the main purpose of this shovel. And I have another kind of shovel. This is a flat edge shovel. If you look at this, flat edge, actually it's a kind, I bought it recently. The purpose of this, you can use multi-purpose, like multi-purpose, because you see, if you want to cut the grass edges, see, this is very precise and very sharp. And if you look at this angle, where you can just put, so you can cut it very, very easily, and you can make the very straight edge. And you can use this for when you are doing the composting, transferring from one place to another place, or taking out the soil from the trailer and all. So it's useful, but the main purpose, this flat edge is really useful, make the sharp edges and all. So the next one is the garden fork. We call it the garden fork. I use this a lot of times while planting perennials and small shrubs and all. So basically I use, dig the ground and make a little way to, hole. Then I use my hand tools to dig further and all. But initially, if I want to make the hole or plant shrubs and perennials, I use this garden fork. It's really useful. And I have been using this thing probably 4 or 5 years. And I have a lot of handy and very camp hand trowels, hand cultivator and all. I have multiple tools because sometimes we all family members work in the garden. So if you see the hand trowel, we have this one. This one is a hand trowel, and this one also, but this is a slightly different. If you look at this edge, is saw type design, but we use to dig the holes, and planting time we use a lot, and this one to put the compost and all, really useful. And we have the hand cultivators. We really use a lot on the garden beds and all, specifically the front yard. We have the flower bed and all, so we use these hand cultivators a lot, and this is really useful, powerful also, if you look at the design. And this is the very basic of the hand fork. And we have a kind of two-in-one. It's the same design. We just bought a couple of years ago, and sometimes we just use to make the hole or plant. And if we have any small weeds here and there, I can rake and take out the weeds and all. So it's a kind of two-in-one tool. It's useful. That's all about the garden tools. I want to give an explanation in this video. I just forgot. Just this one is just a sharpening tool. You know, you can just sharpen and make it very sharp and use it again. It's not expensive. It's just few bucks. You can get in the stores. And okay, here is the another tool I normally don't use much because we don't have much trees around my house. This is our new house. We moved to this house like 1.5 years ago, but our old house has a lot of trees. And also this one is a compact saw and it has a locking system here, so when you press this and you can open it. And if you look at this, the design is really very powerful, sharp teeth, edges and all, and it's very really useful to cut the branches and all. It's really useful, especially for fall cleaning and yard cleaning time. It's really useful and it's very compact. You can just fold it and fold it and use it. And I just want to add a personal comment here. So when you are using this sharp edge garden tools like this compact saw or hori knife or that weeder tool, all those things and all, be careful. Childrens are not playing with these tools because these are really very sharp, so we don't want to get hurt our kids. Yeah, so it's just that's a personal advice. I think I covered all the tools what I want to explain, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I have a few more items to show you, but I will try to cover in the it's not the tools, but it's garden essentials. I will cover in my next video. Thank you very much for watching Housetalk channel.